Hi guys, welcome to a new episode of our series History of the Church. Today we are going to travel back through time to the 4th century of Christianity. As we previously discussed, since the year 64 AD under Emperor Nero, the Christianity has been under persecution. So from the year 64 AD till the year 284 AD, the church had suffered 9 persecutions. In the beginning, Christianity was persecuted as a Jewish sect, but later on, from the middle of the 2nd century, it was persecuted as a separate religion. In the beginning as well, these kind of persecution were localized, but later on, since the year 249 AD, Emperor Decius issued the first imperial-wide persecution against Christianity. The least to describe these kind of persecutions that they were savage and barbaric, and thousands of people lost their lives during these persecutions. Now we go to the year 284 AD, where Emperor Diocletian came to power. And this year is very specific and special for the Coptic Orthodox Church, because the church considers this year as the starting year of the Coptic calendar, or also known as the Martyrs' calendar, and we will know in a few moments the reason behind that. Later on in the year 285 AD, after Diocletian came to power, due to the large extent of the empire, he splitted the empire into two parts, the eastern part under his reign and the western part under Emperor Maximian. Emperor Diocletian had problems with religions, so in the year 297 AD, he persecuted Manichaeism and its ideology by burning and destroying anything related to Manichaeism. He all the time tried to stress on the concept of the divine king. And also with the envy of the pagan priests, also they started to criticize Christianity and accuse Christians to be the reason behind the rage of the idols. And because their failure to foretell the future during some pagan practices, they accused Christianity to be the reason behind that. So they pushed Emperor Diocletian to issue the first edict against Christianity, and that was on the 23rd of Feb in the year 303. And as a result of this first edict of persecution, a big church in Nicomedia was destructed, and that was actually the trigger for the 10th persecution against Christianity, which is historically known as the Great Persecution. Diocletian later on, he stepped down in the year 305 AD. Only 2 years after the first edict of persecution, due to his sickness, he was forced to step down, and later on his son-in-law, Emperor Galerius, came to power, and he continued the persecution until the year 311, and the continuation of persecution was even more severe and more barbaric. On the Egyptians specifically, saying, "Such was the conflict of those Egyptians who contended nobly for religion in Tyre. Some offered their heads bravely to those who cut them off, some died under their tortures, and others perished with hunger, and yet others were crucified. Some according to the method commonly employed for male factors, others yet more cruelly, being nailed to the cross with their heads downward and being kept alive until they perished on the cross with hunger." And now let's go together and take some examples of the great martyrs who shed their blood for the Lord Jesus Christ during the Great Persecution. For example, we have the great Saint George, who was martyred in the year 303 AD. Saint Agnes of Rome, 304 AD, Saint Catherine of Alexandria, 305 AD, Saint Barbara, 306 AD, Saint Mina, 309 AD, and finally Saint Peter, the Pope of Alexandria, in the year 311 AD. It is mentioned in the Coptic Synaxarium about the Great Persecution, 184 quotations. 184 times the great persecution is mentioned in the Coptic Synaxarium. And some historians say that the number of martyrs from Egypt alone exceeded 800,000. In the year 312 AD, and in an eve of a great battle, Emperor Constantine, who came to power, had a vision. In the middle of the sky, he saw two letters of the Greek words for Christ. Some historians said that he saw the cross in the sky. And he heard a voice saying, "By this sign you shall conquer." The next day, he won the battle decisively. And for his mother, Helena, who was a believer, it was a very short proof that Christian God is the true God. So Constantine's conversion started a new era for Christianity that changed Christianity forever. In the year 313 AD, Emperor Constantine issued what is known as the Edict of Toleration or the Edict of Milan, where he allowed Christians to go back to their jobs, to go back to the army. He promoted Christians in many civil positions, he allowed churches to be built, and he ended by this decades and decades of persecutions against Christians. Many of the churches today as well are still remembered to be built in the time of Emperor Constantine. For example, the Church of Resurrection in the holy city of Jerusalem. Constantine also built a new capital, which is Constantinople, after his name, which is also modern-day Istanbul. And later on, this city is considered one of the important chairs in Christianity, along with Alexandria, Rome, and Antioch. Finally, let's have a look on the major events that happened in the 4th century of Christianity. In the year 301 AD, Armenia has declared itself as the first ever Christian state. In the year 303 to 311 AD, we had the Great Persecution, also known as the 10th Persecution or the Great Persecution. In the year 313, as we said, the Edict of Milan was issued by Emperor Constantine. In the year 321 AD, Constantine's considered Sunday as a holy day for the whole empire. In the year 325 AD, the first ecumenical council ever in Nicaea, and we will discuss it in the next episode. In the year 337 AD, Emperor Constantine died, and many historians said that he was baptized on his deathbed. In the year 341 AD, Saint Frumentius became the first bishop of Ethiopia. And we will discuss also this later, because this represents the importance in relation between the Ethiopian Church and Coptic Church. And by the way, Saint Frumentius was ordained as a bishop by Saint Athanasius the Apostolic. In the year 367 AD, Saint Athanasius sent his famous festal letter or Easter letter, giving the authentication of the New Testament canon, confirming the whole 27 books that we have today in our Bible. In the year 380 AD, Emperor Theodosius declared that Christianity is the official religion of the whole empire. In the year 381 AD, Emperor Theodosius calls for the Second Ecumenical Council of Constantinople. And in the year 393 AD, a council in Hippo confirmed also the New Testament canon in addition to the second canonical books of the Old Testament. These are more references if you want to dig deeper on the topics that we discussed in our episode today. Thank you for watching. See you in the next episode. Pray for us. Bye.